Well, Baz, your second film, Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah.
1996. Yes. You're working with Leonardo DiCaprio,
yes.
Claire Danes, your modern interpretation of Shakespeare. Did you ever think you were taking a risk?
If I had a dollar for everyone, every time someone in America went, Shakespeare, it cannot do box office, you know? I got used to what you might call, if not derision, dispiriting disbelief, but it's water off a duck's back, unless I don't believe. But if I believe, if I see it, I mean, I'm not being pretentious. I can't get away from what's in my head.
What was it like working with Leonardo DiCaprio, Claire Danes?
I mean, it was pre-Titanic. I saw him in a magazine. I said, that boy looks like Romeo. I wonder if he can act. The next week he was nominated, I think, for Gilbert Grape or something. I was like, oh, he's really an actor. I fly to L.A. I meet him at Fox. He's really tall. I was surprised how tall he was. And really lovely. Like, just lovely. I said, look, I can't tell you to do this show, but come to Australia. I'll pay for a diving trip. Come down, bring your friends, hang out, let's make video versions of it. And we did. And he came down and he cashed in all of his tickets, his business class tickets, flew economy, brought all his friends, and they were they're in the video tests. Mm-hmm. They're in the scenes shot here under the bridge. I showed that to 20th Century Fox. He did that to help me convince Fox to make the movie. I show Fox, they go, hey man, I guess kind of gangs, right? Okay, but here's $5, go and make it, you know?
Tell me about your relationship with Nicole Kidman, because she is another actor who you work very closely with. She's appeared in two of your films,
and
Moulin Rouge
Chanel.
And Australia, and of course, and Chanel.
And actually, when we were guest editors of Vogue, I did with her, with Nicole. It's the first time I worked with her. And we shot in LA this whole celebration of Australian fashion. And even her then husband is in one of the shoots. And that's the first time I worked with Nicole.
Well, tell me about the friendship. Tell me about the chemistry that you both share.
I mean, every time we come together, there's such intense projects. There's usually some remarkable, extraordinary personal thing going on in our lives. I mean, it's well documented in Moulin Rouge. I lost my father day one. She broke up with her then husband at the end of the movie. I really like her. In fact, I love her. And I think she has love for me. She has love for my wife, my children, and I have love for her partner and her children. You know, we're family friends.
So you will work with Nicole on future projects?
I hope so. Hope she'll work with me. I love the idea that I worked with Nicole when she was very young, when she was fully at that very fecund kind of womanly moment. And I hope to work with her when she's like Katharine Hepburn at 70 in Golden Pond. You know, it will be great if she goes, your father loves you.
Hugh Jackman, you worked with him on Australia. Gorgeous man.
How can you not adore Hugh Jackman? I mean, he shouldn't be real. Like, he shouldn't be real. He is a bit like Superman. But he is real. And I know it's easy to go, like, when someone has so much, they are good looking, they are tall, they are, you know, I mean, he and I are very similar physically, but he has beautiful children, an awesome wife. He has a partner like CM is to me, with Debs. They're a team. Yeah. And she is great. She's so full of energy and so full of you know. I love that Yes We Can energy.
Baz, tell me, when your movie is being screened for the first time and in front of an audience, how do you feel?
I mean, it's nothing is up there with a child being born, but it's close. I mean, if you're nervous about I'm going into that room and, you know, if you're having a Caesar or there's going to be birth or whatever, if you're like... You know, I mean, that is what it's like with a movie, because there's something being born.
Not only is it called Australia, but there were comparisons to Gone with the Wind. Were you hoping for Australia to be your masterpiece?
No. I think with Australia, I knew it would be a rough road. In fact, if you look at me, anything I'm saying, I mean, a lot of that, most of that hype, because of the unusual nature of it, a lot of it was not us generated. It was, look, I read about, I'll tell you what I did. I remember seeing in one of my favorite magazines, Condé Nast Traveler, there was a picture, and bless their souls, it was a very nice promotion, but we didn't ask for it. Big doubles page spread saying, Baz Luhrmann's next masterpiece. And I went, we've got lots of trouble here. This is bad. The movie hadn't been made. You know what I mean? And that's bad. I mean, when you're making a movie, you know that's bad, you know?
You'd rather prove them wrong than have to live
up to
standards.
I'd like it to be somewhere between the two.
Yeah.
But that's never going to happen.
You have made four films. Which one is your favourite and why?
Well, you don't relate to your children like that. I mean, I don't have a favourite child. And when you're told this by your own parents, we love you all but differently, you don't believe them, but I love both my children in completely different ways.
Well, can you then give me your favourite scenes from each of your four movies?
I mean, it's funny because I think in all those movies they'll always come back to the key relationship moments. When you start seeing the lead players, the boy and the girl, the man and the woman, when you see play between them, that's everything in a movie. And so it's always the scene like the pool scene in Romeo and Juliet between Claire and Leonardo. I mean, they're so young.
Oh, gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon I vow that tips with silver all these fruit tree tops.
Oh, swear not by the moon.
Strictly Ballroom, again, in the, you know, can I dance with you? How long have you been here?
That's looking good.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I just...
How long have you been here?
2 years. I was just looking for someone.
In Moulin Rouge, really, the elephant scene between Ewan and Nicole, you're never going to get past that because you've got two iconic actors playing out these delicate love relationships.
I do. You see, I've forgotten if they're green or blue.
Now we're going to the private place. Unfortunately, the cameras can't follow us.
Ooh.
No, come on in. Come in here. Someone's actually, there's someone working on in the red room. Do you mind, Jonna?
Hello.
No? That's right, this is Jonathan Redman. It just shows that every nook and... Here's Anna.
Wow.
It says every nook and cranny, there's someone usually working. And what Jono's actually doing, he's working on the Blu-ray of Romeo and Juliet Moulin Rouge. You see that shirt there that Leonardo's wearing? He wore that shirt. That shirt was found in... So that shirt, that's it on the wall. That shirt we found, Kim Barrett found in an op shop in Surrey Hills. We shot that image like years before we did that. It's a complete mess here.
Now...
What are they?
What are they? Just something to put on the mantelpiece.
That's Sam's interior decorating.
A couple of BAFTAs, a few Oscars.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, you know. People have an almost religious reaction to them. To us, it's not that really. When you say something important, no one believes you, but it's not that important. It's important because it puts light on the movies and it sells tickets. And tickets give you artistic freedom. This cloth was on the bed when, actually, you know what? When Nicole is rolling around doing the orgasm scene.
Let's make love.
Make love?
You want to, don't you?
Well, I can't.
No, tell the truth. You feel the poetry.
And she's going like, oh, yes, do it to me, say it to me. Poetry, I love poetry. Yeah, that's her poetry cloth. I want you to use this in the show. I think Anna... with her considerable charms, has got me to do things I normally wouldn't do.
We like that.
We like that.
There's an old saying, I don't know if it made the cut of Australia, but I think, that's right, the driver says, all you got in the end is your story, better make it a good one. And I think that's probably all there is. Your life is a story, and let's hope that it's a good one to tell when you're sitting under a tree with a cup of tea.
Are you happy with your story so far?
It's not a bad first and second act. I feel like the only thing is it's about time, isn't it? I just really feel like I've only just got going.
Well, Baz Luhrmann, an absolute pleasure talking to you. Thank you for joining Talk Catch
Up. Hey, Anna, we have to do that again. I wasn't ready to say goodbye.
show doesn't stop here. You can check out more TalkAsia interviews online at cnn.com/TalkAsia.